A tense encounter on the USS Alabama, early morning, June 19th. A tense calm settled over the USS Alabama, a mighty warship bristling with over 100 guns. The crew, led by Captain John Henry and his radar team, was on high alert. Their newly installed SK-2 radar, a marvel of technology, flickered with an unexpected signal, a massive formation of aircraft 190 miles away. At first, the crew dismissed it as a glitch, but as the blips on the radar held steady, drawing closer at an alarming rate, skepticism gave way to concern. Captain Fred D. Kirtland recognized the gravity of the situation. The Japanese were approaching, unseen. Flashback to early 1943. The USS Alabama, captained by Kirtland and manned by a crew of 2,500, had just completed rigorous training. Their mission, to join the British Home Fleet in the North Atlantic. As part of the Lend-Lease program, the US was aiding its allies. The Alabama's primary role was to safeguard vital convoys traversing the perilous Murmansk Run. This Arctic route supplied the Soviet Union with weapons, ammunition, and food from the US and UK. Now, back in June, the previously unseen Japanese threat loomed large. The Murmansk Run was a brutal gauntlet. The unforgiving Arctic climate brought constant challenges: ice, snow, and fierce weather. But the greatest threat came from the Germans, lurking in the air and sea with warships and bombers. The USS Alabama, a South Dakota-class battleship boasting 129 guns along its 680-foot hull, was designed for heavy firepower. Its role was to guard convoys traversing this treacherous route. Throughout the first half of 1943, the Alabama and its crew braved these harsh conditions, successfully escorting convoys through icy waters. While Allied leaders hoped the Alabama's presence would draw out the mighty German battleship Tirpitz for a showdown, it never happened. Despite facing no major engagements, the Alabama's unwavering vigilance earned them a unique honor, official Soviet recognition for their vital role in protecting their fleets. This was a first for any American ship. In August, the Alabama detached from the home fleet and headed for Norfolk, Virginia, for a much-needed overhaul in preparation for a new assignment. This overhaul offered a chance to significantly improve their defenses. The planned upgrade was a state-of-the-art SK air search radar, a major leap forward in long-range detection against aerial threats. However, due to the pressing need for battleships in the Pacific theater, the Alabama wouldn't receive this upgrade until later. Time constraints forced a delay, sending them onward without the advanced radar. A daring installation and Pacific battles. Captain Kirtland knew the value of the new radar and defied expectations. He ordered the equipment loaded and made the bold decision to install it at sea. The Alabama's radar platform, perched 130 feet above the water on the mast with an additional 30 feet of height, offered a crucial vantage point. However, installing such complex machinery at sea without the aid of massive shipyard cranes was a daunting task. Undeterred, the Alabama's crew, assisted by personnel from a nearby repair shop, tackled this unprecedented challenge. Together, they meticulously dismantled the old radar and installed and calibrated the new SK system, all while navigating the open ocean. This bold decision by Captain Kirtland would prove to be a lifesaver. Following the installation, the Alabama entered the Pacific theater, playing a critical role in protecting carrier groups during the Gilbert Islands landings. December saw the battleship pounding Nauru and escorting carriers before sustaining some damage on its return journey. After repairs, the Alabama joined Task Group 58.2 in January 1944. February brought both triumph and tragedy. The Alabama defended carriers against attacks at Truk, but also suffered casualties from a friendly fire incident. Despite this setback, the ship continued its vital role, supporting strikes in the Caroline Islands and backing up General MacArthur's landings in New Guinea. The lead-up to the Philippine Sea Battle. By May 1944, the Pacific War raged on. The USS Alabama, alongside Task Force 58, prepared for a critical operation, capturing key islands in the Marianas campaign, a stepping stone towards Japan. The US fleet, boasting 15 carriers, 7 battleships, and numerous escort ships, was a formidable force. On June 13th, Alabama's guns roared in a pre-invasion bombardment of Saipan, marking the start of the Marianas offensive. Anticipating this, the Japanese Navy, led by Admiral Ozawa, assembled a counterattack against Admiral Spruance's U.S. 5th Fleet. Early on June 19th, the crew on Alabama's newly installed SK-2 radar was on high alert. Captain John Henry, radar officers and operators detected a massive blip, enemy aircraft, an incredible 190 miles away. Initially dismissed as an anomaly due to the distance, the crew watched intently as the blip persisted and drew closer. Despite skepticism, Captain Kirtland recognized the potential threat. He validated the report, alerting the rest of the fleet. Soon, the battleship Iowa confirmed the detection, erasing any doubts. One by one, ships across the fleet picked up the approaching bogies. This crucial early warning, thanks to the Alabama's radar, gave the U.S. Navy, particularly the carriers and aircraft of Task Force 58, precious time to prepare for the impending aerial assault. The victory and recognition. The ease with which American pilots shot down their Japanese counterparts earned the battle the grim nickname Mariana's Turkey Shoot. This lopsided victory marked a turning point in the Pacific War. American naval aviation had proven its dominance, signaling the decline of Japanese naval power. A key factor in this victory was the early radar warning from the USS Alabama. Their crew's vigilance cannot be overstated. Their actions were acknowledged by high-ranking officers. Vice Admiral Lee commended both the Iowa and Alabama for their initial detection, with special praise for the Alabama crew, radar officer Henry, technical officers Lenoir and Pennebaker, and operators O'Brien and Cook. Rear Admiral Hansen, commander of Battleship Division 9, also sent a direct message to Captain Kirtland, crediting his super alert radar crew with being in large mesure responsible for yesterday's superlative air victory. Following this pivotal moment, Captain Vincent R. Murphy took command in August 1944. The Alabama continued its service in the Pacific for the remainder of the war. Throughout the fall, it saw action in the liberation of the Philippines, the Battle of Leyte Gulf, and at Okinawa. In December, a powerful typhoon battered the battleship. Later that winter, Captain Murphy announced the Alabama would head to the mainland for repairs after 2 successful years at sea. The following April, under a new captain, William B. Goggins, the Alabama sailed for Pearl Harbor. It continued to support Allied forces with vital firepower, earning battle stars for its actions in Okinawa and against Japanese industrial regions. The post-war years and legacy of the USS Alabama. The war's end saw the USS Alabama contribute to the massive Operation Magic Carpet, a logistical feat that brought millions of American servicemen home. The heroine of the Pacific transported roughly 3,700 veterans itself. During its service, Alabama amassed an impressive record, over 218,000 miles traveled, 22 enemy aircraft shot down, and a remarkable 9 battle stars earned in the South Pacific. Decommissioned in 1947, the Alabama's story wasn't over. Faced with potential scrapping in the 1960s, Alabama citizens rallied. They successfully petitioned to preserve the ship as a memorial honoring all state citizens who served. After a months-long journey, the 35,000-ton battleship arrived in Mobile in 1964 to a hero's welcome. It became the centerpiece of the newly established USS Alabama Battleship Memorial Park, opening its doors to the public in 1965. Efforts to fully recognize the Alabama's crucial role in the Battle of the Philippine Sea continued for decades. Retired Army Lieutenant Colonel Stevens Croom spearheaded this mission. Despite initial challenges, his persistence paid off. In 2001, the Naval Historical Center confirmed, through war documents and interviews with radar operators Cook and O'Brien, that the Alabama was the first to detect the approaching Japanese aircraft, a pivotal moment in the battle. Even after all these years, Cook and O'Brien remember the tension of that fateful morning vividly. The initial disbelief and the agonizing wait for confirmation were some of the longest minutes of their lives. Their vigilance serves as a powerful reminder of how a single act of courage can change the course of history.